Hey everyone, this is OJ here coming to you with another episode of Crypto Corner, my weekly podcast. This is episode number 71 and today I'm going to show you how to create a Bitcoin paper wallet in just a few seconds. Stay tuned. Okay, so let's get started. So as I said, I'm going to show you how to create a Bitcoin paper wallet. Paper wallet is considered to be one of the most secure ways to hold your crypto because a paper wallet is basically a private key. And that private key, when you are the owner of that private key, you have full control over your Bitcoin. This is why paper wallets are highly regarded, but also paper wallets could be swiped or imported. These private keys could be imported into many other applications, software applications or hardware even. You can import them into your Ledger, Nano S or Trezor, any of the hardware wallets that I personally use and recommend. For me, a hardware wallet is actually the most secure way because you have extra layers of protection, but a paper wallet is actually quite safe. So how to do it, how to create a paper wallet and how to be truly the owner of your private keys. Let's get started. The first thing that I'm going to do is I will disconnect from the internet, or actually no, the first thing that I need to do is go to that website here, which is bitaddress.org, and I'm going to land on this page. As I land on this page, I'm ready to start creating my paper wallet. As I said, the first thing that I want to do, however, is to turn off my Wi-Fi. I want to be disconnected because for this process, I don't actually have to be connected to the internet. Bitaddress.org is an open source random address generator. And it uses your browser's JavaScript in order to create data locally. So it doesn't actually have to be connected to the internet. You only need to be connected in order to access the website. And once you're on that website, you disconnect. This is the first step. Now, the next thing that I need to do is just move my mouse all around the page here, anywhere on the website in completely random movements. And I have to move it all the way until this here gets to 100%. As soon as it gets to 100%, my private key has been created. And the private key is the actual wallet. Now, so the private key is here. As you can see here, it says private key. It also says in red secret, because this is really what you need to protect. This is the code that connects you to the blockchain. And if you send any Bitcoins to this address, this private key is what is going to allow you to work with these coins, whether you are sending them to someone else, you know, spending them, whatever you're doing. The Bitcoin address that you need in order to receive Bitcoins into this wallet is in green here. This is the public key. It says share. So if someone wants to send you Bitcoin, or if you are going to be sending yourself Bitcoin from another wallet or maybe from an exchange, from something else, mining company, whatever, you will have to provide this wallet address. So this is the public key. This is what you share. This is the private key. This is what you keep secret. The next thing that I'm going to show you, you can go here straight to print, or you can go to paper wallet, and by default you will have three of these and you can print these. It looks, you know, really nice. You have the public key on the left, the private key is on the right. In order to spend Bitcoin from this wallet, you will need to access the private key. In order to receive, you will need the public key. So the left side of this paper is what you can share with other people. The right one really needs to stay secret. Okay, as you can see here, we have a BIP38 encryption. This allows you to add a passphrase, such as a password or maybe a few words, in order to encrypt your wallet even more. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to select this option. I'm going to hide the art because this way it's going to show me my keys written so that I can copy and paste easier. I'm not using a QR code scanner for this. This is why I'm not going to be working with this QR code. So let's say I want to add a passphrase that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now this is too easy, of course. You have to choose something better, but this is just for the sake of this tutorial. And I'm going to generate two addresses only. I don't really need 7 right now. and I'm going to click generate. So what's happening right now is I'm generating new private keys and public keys, basically new wallets. As you can see, I have here encrypted private key. It tells me that it's password protected and that I will be required to enter that password if I want to access the information from this private key. And I can show you how that works. If I go here to wallet details, I can paste that private key, which I just copied, and I can go to view details. It doesn't allow me to do that unless I enter my passphrase. My passphrase is 12345. If I enter it wrongly and I try to decrypt that wallet, I'm going to get a message saying that I'm using the incorrect password or passphrase for this encrypted private key. So I really need to be able to remember what is the passphrase, or maybe I write it somewhere. I would say you need to have this written somewhere else. As I enter the correct one, it's going to decrypt my wallet, and now I'm going to be able to see the details of that wallet. And I can see the public key and the private key. And this is the Bitcoin address. So if I want to receive, again, this is the address that I need to share with someone who is going to be sending me Bitcoin. Okay, let's go and check the other address. So it was in paper wallet. So this is my second private key. And this private key is also password protected. So I go to wallet details. I'm going to paste this one. I'm going to click on view details. And as you can see, it's not showing me anything. I need to enter the passphrase. It is 12345. If I enter the wrong one and I try to decrypt it, again, I'm going to get the same message that is going to tell me that I'm using the wrong passphrase, which is great. This shows me that it actually works. So I need to enter the correct passphrase. And then I'm able to decrypt my wallet, and I'm able to see what are the details, what is the private key, the public key, the addresses, and everything else that I can see here for this wallet address. So this is how you do it. It's really simple, very quick process, bitaddress.org. Don't try to search for it, just type it straight away, bitaddress.org, or you can grab it from the description in this video. I added it in the description box, so you can grab it from there or you can type it. I don't advise you to search for it because in Google search, there's always advertising links that come up on the top of the search. And sometimes, rarely, but sometimes, these could be phishing websites. So they can actually be fake websites made to look exactly as the original. And if you're entering private data, sensitive data, such as private keys and stuff like that, it is not very safe. So this is why I just type bitaddress.org or grab the link from below the video. Thank you guys for watching, and I'm gonna see you in the next episode. Also, for those of you who are not yet subscribed to my channel, you might want to subscribe. I'm gonna show you why. I have a special summer giveaway, and this is the announcement. Announcing my special summer giveaway. Yes, to celebrate the arrival of summer, I'm doing a special summer giveaway on my YouTube channel for all of my subscribers. I'd like to get to know you better, and I want your feedback on my content. In return, I'm giving away not one, not two, but 10 great prizes. 5 physical Revolut debit cards. Revolut is an online bank with zero fee conversion of all major currencies, including Bitcoin and Ethereum, and it's my favorite card to use on my travels. Also, I'm giving away crypto prizes, $50 worth of Bitcoin, $50 worth of Ethereum, $25 worth of Litecoin, and $25 in Dash. And the grand prize, my favorite hardware wallet device, the Ledger Nano S. Compact, secure, and anonymous, the Ledger Nano S is everything you need to store safely your long-term crypto holdings. For your chance to win, all you have to do is like and comment on my videos from now until August, when I will select the winners. You also have to be a subscriber, of course, but it's free to subscribe, so this is your chance to win these fantastic prizes. You are in charge with your luck. The most active subscribers will be rewarded. It's that easy, so get busy.